feeling such bliss.
Hey, class of 2020, we know things have been kind of out of the ordinary lately. You're not going to get a graduation ceremony. So iHeartRadio found some people to write commencement speeches just for you. John Legend, he's in. Hillary Clinton, she's in too. Over 20 of your favorites, from DJ Khaled to Coach K, Abby Wambach to Halsey. Listen to iHeartRadio's new podcast, Commencement. Speeches drop May 15th on iHeartRadio app and Sunday, May 17th across all iHeartRadio stations. Brought to you by Doritos, taking the class of 2020 valedictorians to another level.
Feel better faster.
HopeUrgentCare.com.
Things you need to know right now.
Hey, we got $1,000 right now. Text Nationwide keyword thanks. That's T. Hanks, my buddy, Tom Hanks. Thanks to the number 200-200. Thanks to the number 200-200. You get a confirmation text and all that stuff right back at you. When you are in the running then for $1,000, text a few times too. Thanks to the number 200-200. Officials are continuing to ease lockdown orders in L.A., announcing that all retailers can now reopen for curbside pickup. Tennis courts, equestrian centers, bike parks, and community gardens are also allowed to reopen. However, basketball courts, volleyball courts, and baseball fields remain closed. Neighborhood leaders can now close certain streets to cars as well in order to give residents more space for recreational activities. It's still unclear when Governor Newsom will allow gyms to reopen, but 24 Hour Fitness has revealed a plan for what their clubs will look like. Their gyms will be open for an hour at a time, then they'll be closed for 30 minutes for deep cleaning, then open again for another hour. Oh my gosh. Members will also need to make a reservation to work out using an app. In Texas, some 24 Hour Fitness locations are set to reopen on Monday.
I'm not totally sure where it was, but I thought it was funny, all those the protesters that wanted the gyms to reopen, they went in as a sign of protest. They were doing like push-ups and stuff outside of a courthouse.
Oh, really?
But their form of protesting was showing that you could just work out at home. They were doing all these exercises. Like, yeah, you don't need the gym. You're right.
Right. Do it at your house. Californians that are currently unable to pay their rent could possibly have their payments covered as part of a $25 billion aid package. 4.5 million people in the state have filed for unemployment benefits, and officials have moved to delay evictions. This, of course, raised the concerns from landlords who could possibly face foreclosure. The Senate solution would give landlords tax credits equal to the value of their missed payments, while tenants would have 10 years to pay back their missed rents. There you go. Those are three things you need to know. Coming up next, what's the strangest thing you've done during quarantine? Jill has a few examples. Are these yours or are people listening to our show?
No, this is what I'm doing.
These will be the best you've ever heard. Oh my gosh, just please stay through this song. It's going to be amazing. She always has the best stuff. We'll do that coming up next. 104.3 MyFM.
I had a dream. I got everything I wanted. Not what you think. And if I'm being honest, it might have been a nightmare. To anyone who might care, thought I could fly, so I stepped off the golden. Nobody cried, nobody even noticed. I saw them standing right there. Kinda thought they might care.
Thank you.
MyFM's Balance in the Morning. We have Katy Perry on the show at 8:25 tomorrow. She's zooming in. I don't know what I'm going to do about my hair. I'm going to try and look good, put on a college shirt and all that stuff, but yeah. Who's kidding who? You know?
You put the shirt on.
Oh, yeah. No, I'll put a college shirt on. Yeah. Maybe. I don't know. You know? Who knows? We'll see what the day brings, right? So, Jill, you're at home. You're alone. You're doing weird stuff.
Yeah, I started noticing that I was kind of doing weird things once I started talking to the pictures I have around the house. Like, I have a picture in my room of my best friend, Jen, the two of us from her wedding. And I was in bed, and I can see it from my bed, and I was laying there, and I was thinking about something, and I just turned and I go, right, Jen? And just, like, did not even mean to do it. Oh. Just felt the need to talk to her, and I'm like, ooh, okay. And I found myself doing it more and more with different people throughout my house. Mm-hmm. And then I found myself, like, I have some stairs here in my townhome, and I have three stairs on the first little floor here, and then you have to turn and go up the rest of the stairs.
It's a landing. It goes to your landing.
Okay, sure. I found myself going up the stairs, and then I would do, like, a little, like, dance move, and then go up the rest of the stairs. Like, I was going up in, like, some Broadway musical. And I don't even, the thing is, I'm not thinking about doing it. I just do it.
That one doesn't surprise me at all. That's something I would have thought you'd been doing for years. That's very new.
They haven't surprised me. Even talking to the pictures, it's like a little Harry Potter world. And as long as they don't talk back to you, you're fine, I suppose. But none of that surprises me, you know?
Okay, well, that's good. You know, that just proves I'm just kind of a weirdo to begin with.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, we had no doubt about that.
I know, I am a weirdo. But I told you guys this before, I started noticing every time we would do the Battle of the Sexes, no matter who the guy was, I had a picture of him in my mind and he was an attractive man. Every single guy that called in to Valentine's Party.
Yeah,
okay, good.
Fine.
Okay. Great, I feel so much better.
That made a lot of guys feel pretty good, knowing that they called it the Battle of Sexes.